Hey, Shalom, Shalom. For the sound of famous one, give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushai, Hashem, and Kapadash. The Lord honors the elders and your apostles of great men, to me well. Salvation to the appearance of the truth and sincerity to the four corners of the earth. We want to act what's personal and being obedient to their husband. So, you know, the respectable Israel who wake up to the truth. You know, knowing that they are Israelites. Hey, Brother Howard from the GMS, prophetic vibration camp. Back on the century, respect and power of Hashem, Yahushai. So, you know, through the spirit and power of Hashem Yahushai, you know, I was having a scripture in Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6, and say, for thou art an holy people unto Yahweh, thy power. So we know that with holy, go back to separate, because the Lord made us separate among the nations. Because when they go into Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5, it say, behold, I taught you statutes and judgment, even as thou, even as Yahweh thy power commanded me, that ye shall do them in the land whatsoever ye go to possess. Keep therefore and do them, for there is your, for this is your wisdom and your knowledge and your understanding, Selachiah, in the sight of nations which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people. So we're back into Deuteronomy 7:6. So you understand why Yahweh Hashem Yahushai made us separate, because he was given the laws by Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, and ought to follow them, you know, in every land that we go to possess. So, you know, hey, that is sure that we had to be, you know, happy within the spirit, you know, rejoicing within the spirit, giving all praises and honor and glory to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, that he chose us to be that special people unto himself, that he gave us the law, you know, to you know, to be amongst, you know, living amongst each other, how to act, how to function, how to be in order, you know, be disciplined, and not like these heathens, because these heathens is anything, you know, eat anything, drink anything, you know. Chamber with animals, chamber with their family is like, you know, is a lot of filth, you know, with these other nations, you know, worshipping idols, worshipping themselves, you know. And that's why the Lord said, envy not your precious and choose none other way, because even in the scriptures, the Lord said, if I drip from a bucket, fall out, if you wouldn't tell me, I can pick up that and die with the heathens is. But yet, Israel would not choose to be like that drop, will fall out from the bucket, which is nothing. They want to class themselves as nothing, because they're watching the heathens, you know, having the, because the wicked rule the world, and the sad nation, you know, inherit from it, from Esau, Edom, you know, putting us into sleep. All of them have a hand when they read Psalm 83, you know, all of them have a hand in our captivity. So they actually stunting, you know, physically. They're physically stunting in their kingdom, you know, but Israel so caught up in vanity that they are lost. Within the vanity, they making, because the flesh is of this world. The flesh is vanity. So everything you see, you will be running and chasing behind. You know, as how the heathens has lived. The heathens has lived for vanity. It's actually the Elamites who live in Trinidad. Elamites kill each other, kill out their own brother or their own sister, their father, their mother for land. They hang themselves when a woman leave them or horn them. Which is get them born, as they say in Jamaica, or cheat, as they say in America. You know, so you actually know that our people is going through by their following. That's why the Lord said, don't follow the heathens and choose none of their ways, because we are a special people unto himself. We were given the laws by Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. When they go in Deuteronomy 28 from 1 go up to 15, the Lord tell you all the blessings when they continue following the laws, which is our wisdom, understanding, and our knowledge. You know, how to act, how to function in the truth, you know, knowing, you know, loving a brother like how you love yourself, you know, looking for a brother, you know, and just bringing forth that love through the congregation, that love within the righteousness, you know, being fair, being just, you know. So I just, you know, joyful in the spirit that you have about you, shall wake me up in the truth and let me know, hey, you are a special. You are a special, you know, we are a special elect, you know, which is, you know, the hopeful elect, we are a special people unto Yahweh Shimon Shai. Because these two thirds wanna go down to Egypt. These two thirds wanna envy the oppressors and choose their ways. You know? They don't know how you know important we are to Yahweh Shimon Shai, being the apple of his eye. You know? We have our ultimate power to serve. You know, these other nations had their military might and their nuclear thinking, you know, they worshiping in their own strength, which is carnality, you know, in a weapon of destruction. But it's in control of all these nuclear weapons, these smiths, they could say, who created them, going back to the scientists and all of them who created it, because, you know, we know that Yahweh Shimon Shai is in control of all things. The hammer, the world, which is Esau, Edom, and all the rest of the heathens, you know, on the face of the earth. But the Lord mainly dealing with Israel. So the Lord actually making us go through the fire, you know, by testing us and trying us in his flesh to see if we will fall in the world or we go go into the straight gate, you know, which is when dwells righteousness, you know, going to the kingdom of heaven, putting on that heavily kingdom, that mindset of the kingdom of heaven, you know, being a man. Being a king on the whole, being a king and having that righteous mindset to judge righteously and justly, you know, knowing how to set things in order, you know, putting things in place how it's supposed to be, you know, and judging righteously, you know, not being unfair in you know, dealing with the heathens is a whole different story, because we had a double cup onto them. But Israel, what I talking about? Talking about these special people, you know, how to deal with our wives and our children, and how to, you know, see what our kingdom we will be ruling. So that reminds that Yahweh Shimon Shai, you know, waking up the elect, you know, to be in this time and putting on the old armor, putting on that kingmanship mentality. You know, we can't be in the street and being little boys, we gotta be men, you know, knowing that, hey, because sometimes when I run these jigs, they be thinking so kind of like my mind be out of this world. You know, out of this world, like going back into Colossians, I think it's 3:1, you know, set the afflictions and things above. So I was thinking about the kingdom of heaven, how we going to be the judgment, visualizing terror in my mind. You know, some heathens is get you so much, you know, stir you up, get you angry, because the old days we're talking about adultery, about vain things. But you was a man, Lord, you warning them, you was warning them, but they ain't taking heed, you know. I keep on warning my family, they ain't taking heed by any idea. I know it's my mission. But that's why I always keep on saying, I know it's my mission and I ain't turning back. You know, hopefully Yahweh Shimon Shai, you know, sustain me in this truth. You know, that's why I be praying for him to take the rock out away from me. So right, every little time I be meditating on Yahweh Shimon Shai, because he tell us we are a special people unto himself, you know. So we go down into the scripture, it say, Yahweh, thy power had chose thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So if you want to follow the ways of the heathens, you know, you bringing yourself low, because we are above, you know, we are above, you know, we are Israel, you know, it's a Kwame Yasharela rise Israel, because we always on top. But what we do, we went off, you know, what we do with this, we turn from the lower statutes and commandments, which is our wisdom, knowledge, and understanding in the sight of all the nations. So we come like you following, you know, you following the blind, because they don't have wisdom, knowledge, and understanding in their part. All they just running behind is vanity and vexation, well, vanity and more vanity, and that way our people adapt being among the heathens. You know, I think about scripture here, my guy. This is the book of this is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 4 from 27 Salak, yeah? And Yahweh shall scatter you among the nations, and ye shall be left few in numbers among the heathens, whether Yahweh shall lead you, and they shall serve gods, the work of men hands, wood, stone, which neither see nor hear nor eat nor smell. So let's just show you that our people, you know, going astray while worshipping all their gods. The big image where Esau Edom portray is Cesare Borgia, you know, where they could reach the world, you know, and they call Jesus, which we know that they have no J in the Hebrew language. But our people, Hosea 4:6, they just destroy for lack of knowledge, and they believe in lying words. So the gods of this world shall fool them and keep them in that mindset of believing in an idol god and an idol name, which we know the Yahweh Shinosha is our strong tower, and the lack alone will run to it. You know? So we knowing that we are a special people unto Yahweh Shinosha above all people on the face of the earth. We have to give Yahweh Shinosha all our praises, because we was men once in the dark. We was once in the dark, lost, you know, in committing adultery, fornication, smoking. Hey, name it, brothers, things brothers we don't want to talk about, what brothers do, you know. But the how about Shimon Shai wake us up? You know, that's why it's always called the scripture. Let me bring it up, Peter. The book of Peter, chapter 2, verse 9. And it read, but ye are his chosen generation, a royal priesthood. So you have about Shimon Shai, as I was saying earlier on, he perfecting us to be that royal priesthood, you know, to be kings, you know, to be leaders, you know. Is only the like is alpha males, you know, like how it had in the jungle, it had the lion, you know, he's the alpha male, you know, and he have is you know his women around them, yeah, by the dozens, you know, yeah, you know, a half a dozen, wherever it go, and in this kingdom, they portray the woman as the head, they portray the woman as the god, so these men will be running behind a piece of ass and worshiping the ass like the ass is a god. You know, just I think just last night I was watching my cousin was showing me some things on TikTok that, you know, a chick actually kissing a woman ass, and I'm like, he worshiping that ass, you know, have himself loaded to the ground, lie down, and she in the pool, and she has cock, she has, and he actually kissing it. To just show that these men was want to please their flesh, because the flesh is actually, you know, over their spirit, because their spirit is sinking their body, their spirit, I can't even say they actually have a spirit, because the flesh don't take over their vessel, and demons, you know, in them, because why, when you're running on things of this world, it actually adapts spirits on you. I don't have no, everything is spirit, everything is vexation, vanity, and spirits, you know, that's why it is in the book of Ecclesiastes, everything is vanity and vexation and spirit, you know. But we as men of the Lord, we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. So Yahweh Shimosha choose us to show the light, to bring forth that light in this dark world. We are the light of the world, you know. We wake up in this time, you know, to spread that light to the elect. So it's just, you know, it's like you in the dark, in a dark room, and you are spraying candles, you know, in every corner, all in the middle and filling the room with light that pertaining to the world. We are around the world and spreading that light, you know. But with the scripture say, all people choose darkness rather than light, but the elect alone, you know, will run into that straight gate, you know, going into that light, you know, and waking up and paying that, and you know, lighting us, bring that fire, which is your kakodash within ourselves. You know, having fear, Yahweh is one of the key point in this truth to spark that fire, which, because it's saying Proverbs 1:7, the fear Yahweh is beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. So we gain the knowledge from by fear Yahweh with an understanding, and we gain wisdom. We pray for a lot of things for Yahweh to boost us up in the spirit, you know. So that when we wake up and being a royal priesthood, we perfecting ourselves to be kings, to be rulers on this face on the face of the earth, ruling over all the nations on the face of the earth, as the scriptures say, you know, as it was in the beginning, so it shall be in the end. And we always on top. We was on top, so we going back on top. And this time we will stay on top forever and ever and ever and everlasting. You know? It have no turning back, it have no changing, you know. Because the like is perfecting ourselves, because we seeing what is wickedness, we seeing when the wicked rule in the earth, you know, how the world is out of course, nothing is balanced, you know. You might want something and can't get it, it have limits in everything, you know. That will show you that, hey, Esau, Edom have a ruling in this physical world, and it sucks, it's boring, you know. For everything, you gotta have visa, you gotta have your ID card, you gotta have your license, you know, you gotta have money. All this shit is bullcrap. But in the kingdom of heaven, everything is done in an order where it have no, you know, to the elect, you know, being delivered up, knowing that you will be a king. It have no limit in nothing. Even your lifespan, it have no limit. It goes on and on and on and on. So you not having a thought of when you gonna die, or if you gonna die, or if you gonna get sick. It have nothing like that once you've been elect. So you being chosen to be a royal priesthood until you have Bashem Mashiach. You should be rejoicing in the spirit to know that you get up this morning and you could face the east and pray until you have Bashem Mashiach and thank him for being in this truth and waking up, not having stress about thinking about bills or thinking about their wicked Eve, these demons out here, you know. Because a lot of women out here have demons on them. Your Eve have demons on them, you know. Still cheering and even coming again, so they have demons on them the same way. You know, it has some good ones in the Eve and good ones in the train, putting them in order. But it has some majority is demons, you know. By NID, you knowing that, hey, you in the shoot and Yahweh Shemesha is with you. Yahweh Shemesha is on your side. What man shall be, what Esau and all these other nations and even two-thirds of our people could do you. Nobody cannot break you. You pay your bills, if you lose the last 500, you're the paying bills. Hey, you smile. Because you know, as Baruch saying in Baruch 3 and 8, we are yet this day in our captivity, which we are subject to payments. So why we on our payments, we are rejoiced, because it always is part of trials and chastisement and all these things. You know, imagine you had to pay for water to drink. A daily time we're living in. You understand? So that was, hey, you had to be rejoicing in the spirit that you wake up to this truth and knowing that Yahweh Bashem Yashai is on your side. You know? Know that he chose you to be a royal priesthood and holy people, a holy nation. Going back into the book of First Peter 2:9, and that holy go back to separate nation. So the elect is actually separate from even these two-thirds, even our own people, we are separate from. I want you to say, God, I nation of desire, going back into the elect. Because tutors not, hey, they not desire any Yahweh Shemesha, they didn't desire any return of Yahweh Shemesha, they didn't even desire freedom, you know, from this flesh. They want to be delivered up. They want to get destroyed, and they want to go down by, but they want to go down, they want to make a covenant with death, than choose life, and get salvation through Yahweh Shemesha coming into this truth. They rather be wicked, you know, and serve other gods, you know, and get destroyed, like when the Lord swallowed them up when Moses come out from, you know, Mount Sinai, you know, they was committing that was actually the first party, you know, Israel, a wicked party, which is kind of what we have in Trinidad, you know. They started, you know, drink and party and commit adultery and a lot of shit and worshiping idols, you know. They were all these demons, and it was started to overtake them. And it's the same thing in this time, so the Lord is going to destroy them by fire. The second death is by fire this time. Thermal nuclear fire, the Lord is going to cleanse the earth by. So if you don't want to be that royal priesthood, that holy nation, which is separate from the world, from two-thirds, from the other nations, you know, Yahweh Shemesha, you know, but that doesn't show you how dread this truth is. If you don't want to be that holy nation, if you don't want to be that chosen people, you're going to get put to death. So it's either you choose light or choose darkness, and our people will choose darkness. That we go into Colossians, it say, I think it's 1 Colossians 7:14, when it say, if my people change from their wicked ways, the Lord shall, you know, send a good word to Yahweh. This is a roughly paraphrasing. And you know, the Lord shall forgive them for their sins. But two-thirds will, they just want to continue in their wickedness. They want to add sin upon sin, you know. But the Lord say, peculiar people, that he should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of the darkness into the marvelous light. So we have to show that light. We have to show that marvelous light by going out on the highways and byways and prophesying and talking things to existence, from the apostles, elders, going down to the younger brothers, you know. Everybody had to be watching you and saying, you know, hey, this brother already changed. You know, he was so, and he was this, and he was that. Now, hey, the Lord actually, you know, his brother, you know, hey, humble, you know, meek, you know, always stretch out a hand, you know, but we do actually, to the wicked, we really give to the wicked, give to the brothers. And they, when they see the congregation come around, they will say, hey, them brothers and them functioning in their love. You know, you ain't gonna be seeing you up on your brother down. So you making sure your circle up, your church pop, the Lord say, hey, you know, that why paying tithes and giving charity is all that is keeping the ministry up, keeping the church up, building that spiritual house of King David. We had to start by making sure that all brothers, you know, love our brother like how we love himself. And making sure all brothers up, even though, you know, brothers had to go through the chastisement, but you be there with their brother, as well as what was going on with Job. They come on and was going and going through it with Job same way. They rock with Job. So same way brothers had to rock with each other, you know. Don't afraid to come out and let brother know what's going on in your household. You know, it has certain brothers who they're close with, he gonna breed that sword will sharpen, you know, with you, but you is a sword. So he gonna calm you down and ease you with the word. And tell you things you wanna hear. Not these wicked two-thirds, not your mother, not your sister, not your brother, but our brother in the truth. You know? So that's why we hire special people from all these other wicked two-thirds and these other nations. Because why? We following the laws of Yahweh Shimoshai and making wisdom and understanding the stability of the time we're living in. You know how to operate, how to react, how to act, you know, in every situation, you know. How to maneuver certain situation by using wisdom, you know. Because we know a lot of these women don't get it, they don't get it. But we all know to use wisdom when we come into them same way, you know. So we have to say all praises to Yahweh, you know, and we come up from that darkness into the marvelous, and we pray now with that woman and putting on the spiritual armor, Yahweh, you know, shy. So we ought to be focused on our salvation, feed the sheep. Feed the sheep, as I was trying to tell Peter, you know. We had to fear the Lord. We had to know that, hey, we are on a mission, and we still fulfill our mission, you know, through praying, fasting, and keep on pushing your word, and continue being laborers for Yahweh Hashem Yoshai. And that we will get paid when Yahweh Hashem Yoshai come. And that spiritual penny is just multiplying. Why, daily, as you praying all this work. You know, so I just wake up within the spirit, you know, now come from work, you know, was sleeping, you know, and because I just went out in the sea and, you know, whole our vibes, you know, and I ain't really work, you could say work, but I was just there with my brother and, you know, teaching him what he would, because it's a yapa thing to wake up, you know, Israel, and let them know the truth and even warn them, you know, and come with us, our spirit rejoicing that Yahweh Hashem Shai choose me to be a special people unto himself. You know, knowing that, or knowing all the parables, you know, through, you know, he had the elders and the apostles breaking it down for us, and for me understanding it, can I understand then, which is the Rakako that's actually working within me to understand the parables, you know, and, you know, choosing me to be, you know, to be one of his laborer, you know, to be, you know, called within, you know, in that being in that circle of the hopeful elect, knowing that I have a chance holding this ticket and praying that, hey, my number call, you know. So, hey, to the spirit and power, Yahweh Hashem Yoshai, you have to fear Yahweh Hashem Yoshai. And that is the spirit I always have on me, fearing him, because I know I went through, it's about a testimony where I went through a lot. I went through a lot. I actually, you know, get the plague of the mind, end up in a mad ward in the hospital. All kind of things happened to me, Lord. I'm running naked in cities. All kind of thing, because I was prideful, like my pride was up on the roof. You know, I was studying women, I was studying to ball and stunt, you know, and play pimp, you know. And the Lord wake me up and show me, hey, this is not your path. This is your path. And the Lord show me my path. So I still fulfill my path by pushing this word and doing what Yahweh Hashem Yoshai sent me on earth to do, to fulfill my mission, to serve him, you know. If my head had to be on the guillotine, and for Yahweh Hashem Yoshai, pray, please. You know, if I had to die for Yahweh Hashem Yoshai, so let it be done. It's Yahweh Hashem Yoshai will. Let it be done. You know? Because I'm not serving these fucking no man. I'm not serving no man. The only power I'm serving is Yahweh Hashem Yoshai. No man can make me serve them. Especially no fucking wicked white man. You know, no fucking pale skin looking like they're fucking walking dead. You know? The filthy fucking flesh-eating motherfuckers can make me serve them. You know, neither they're fucking wicked fucking women. You understand? Who Job said they been gonna play the dogs with fucking them. You know? So, hey, that is a show you're talking about. So they just turn me up in spirit to fucking slaughter. I wanna slaughter these fuckers. You know? So, hey, hope this video be edifying. Brother, stay in the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yoshai. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashim, Yoshai, Bashim, Kakodash. About understand the elders and the apostles of great men to know really well. Suggestion to the academic opportunity students inside the folk on the side of the earth. To the world to act what's listening and learning, being obedient. Key will be obedient, you know, because these women, as brothers doing videos on these women said, no, they get themselves right for the coming of the Lord, you know, for they will get destroyed, you know. To the aqua to listen and learn, being obedient, to the Akiam Salakia, who special instruct to the four corners of the earth, you know, a serving Yahweh, Shem Shai, being laborers, knowing that you will not get paid by getting, you know, deliverance, you know, get delivered by Yahweh, Shem Shai, again, which we praying and we waiting for, having faith, you know, in Yahweh, Shem Shai, that he will not deliver us up, you know, until the next one, you know, to the spirit of power, Yahweh, Shem Shai, where the video is edifying, Shalom.